Hello. It's another random collection-y video today. For the first time, I think I can't really remember. It's the first time I've done this in the bedroom. Oh yes. That sounded a bit wrong, didn't it? But this is a random collection-y thing. I don't know why I've never used the bed before, because it's a raised platform and it's easy to set up. And also the bedroom isn't as echoey as the living room, although you might be hearing a little bit of echo there. Maybe that's just me speaking too loudly. So basically today what we're looking at is, you can see a lot of different random bits there, is all unused patches, or well, patches I haven't sewn onto my jackets yet. I will show you the jackets in a moment, but first we're going to go through these. They're a mix of ones that I've bought recently and ones I've bought almost 20 years ago and all sorts, and I'm going to show you which they are. I'm going to put them into different piles. So this is just to put the, just to show you what I've got before they actually go on the jacket. And I've got two jackets to put them on. You will see the jackets when they're done. This is just a little patch collector, patch battle jacket sort of thing. Just for now, just for like a little bit of fun, pass the time. Also a little bit of practice for these sort of things when I do them in the main video for the jacket. So here we go. So basically, right, so let's start from the top. Bone for soup. That's what that is. It's meant to look like an NFL patch. I've had this for probably at least 17 years, because I'm going to be mentioning this place a lot. Geordie Jeans, which was a small chain in the Northeast, used to sell things like this, like sort of like band merch and like kind of patches, that sort of thing. And Bone for Soup didn't really have that much merch, and I was a really big fan of Bone for Soup, especially at the time. I am more so now than I was then. I think I just got it because I like the design, and it like it's quite cool. It's got like a little Texas map on there. This has been removed. This was my jacket that I'm using at the minute. Is actually an old denim jacket from about the same time. Maybe 17, maybe older, maybe 20 years old. This jacket, it's made by Le Shark. When it had sleeves, you'll see it in a moment, when it had sleeves, this was on one of the sleeves, and I've just removed it because I want to keep it, I want to use it, I just don't know where, and it is going to go on the main battle jacket, just I don't know where, even though it's not metal and it's not like punk rock, it's, well it is punk, but it's not like, you know, hardcore or anything. I don't care, it's my battle jacket, I have what I like. So I'm going to put this in a pile called battle jacket, just don't know where. So that's that one. And then next we've got, I'll do these two at the same time. These two are ones that I've just got off Facebook Marketplace. A nice guy off Facebook Marketplace called Sowell. I don't know if you can see that one there because it's a bit dark and I'm trying to use the natural light here. So basically that one there, yeah, you can kind of see it better there. It's Insane Clown Posse. Yep, Insane Clown Posse. I'm not a hardcore juggalo by any means, but I do admire them. I do like the style. I do like the culture. I should really maybe turn on the light for this actually, but yeah, so that, I'll tell you what, I'll rejoin you in a second, I'll just turn the light on. Okay, so sorry for that. So slight change in lighting, and this other one was also from the same seller. I did just want the Beavis and Butthead at first, then I saw this and I thought, because you sell them for about £2 each, I thought, why not? And these ones look like they're iron-ons, but he probably sewed this one because this one's got like some threads hanging off it, so it looks like he's done that. This one's very sticky, so he's either glued it or used the iron-on feature. Which some of these are iron-ons, and they are very easy to apply, and if you get a good one, they do stick. Sometimes they do fall off, so sometimes when you iron them, you do have to re-sew them. So, I really like that one. And obviously because it's like to deal with metal and hard rock, that's definitely going on the main battle jacket, the blue jacket, but denim black blah, battle jacket. And that one's going to go on there as well, just because it's quite fun, quite funny. I don't know if that one's a genuine, like, wonder if it's from one of these private companies, you know, one of the bootleg ones. But they're still good. He also gave me another one, see if I can find it in the pile, actually. Yeah, there it is. This one, I'm not, I mean, this one's apparently to do with Fallout. I'm not a fan of Fallout, but he threw it in because I asked him what it was, and he go and give me these £4 for all 3 cents, so that's really nice of him. And he was apologetic when he was a little bit late. He wasn't that late, actually. I just asked him if he'd post it, and he said, oh, I'm really sorry, I'll send it now. So those three, those two are going on battle jacket. I'm going to do another pile over here of ones I'm going to either donate or sell. I'll explain the donate bit after. And next we're coming up to, I'll do these two at the same time. So this Long Nirvana one and this Square Nirvana one, I don't really know why I got both. I'm still a huge Nirvana fan, so that would explain a lot. But this one here is the preferred one, and this one's definitely going on the battle jacket. Because it fits quite well, there's a part where it fits quite well, and I'm going to show you that in a bit. And this one, I think I just like the design. I did like the long patches, because on the back of this denim one, when I had sleeves, me Nana was lovely enough, God rest her soul, to sew these long ones all the way down the back instead of having a back patch. I didn't actually know that back patches existed then, because I was only about 11 or 12, and she was nice enough to sew them all on there. But this one I actually had a battle hoodie at the time, I just called it the patch hoodie, and I had a lot of these patches on the same hoodie. This one I had on the same hoodie, and I'm definitely going to use this one. This one I'm not 100% sure, as much as I like it, I think it's going in the donate pile. This one is going on the battle jacket pile. Next up we've got, I'm going to show you these two at once actually. Fantastic patches these. Bought this one off eBay, obviously brand new, never used, only about £2.50, no postage charge. Lovely, I love Ghost, they're probably one of the best modern bands at the minute, and probably one that deserves to be on the jacket. When I got it, I thought it was going to be a little bit skinnier. It's around about the same height-ish as that Nirvana one I showed you before, but I don't know, it might go better on my other jacket, the black army jacket slash the black horror slash punk slash goth jacket, which I will show you as well later on the day. So that's going to go in this pile here for that one. Again, this is one that got on eBay last week. When I got this, I was too excited. I had to take it was still this plastic packet with the backing card on it. And what can I say apart from Queen? I think everyone loves Queen. I don't think there's anyone who listens to music who doesn't like Queen. It's like the Beatles, you can't not like them. And obviously my parents and other relatives and friends love Queen as well. So I have Queen represented somewhere on this jacket. That one's a nice royal blue with gold. It's very, more like the 90s sort of greatest hits album. I just like the colour. And it got for a really good price. I think it got for like £2.50 or £3 maybe. And that one's definitely going there. I'm not sure where I'm going to put it, but it's going on there. Now, I'll do these ones. Where's the other? Oh, I've sewn it on, haven't I? I'll do these two together. Right. Clockwork Orange. Lost Boys, both great films, both two of my favourite films. These two, this one's obviously an iron-on, and so is this one, which I didn't realise, but I'm probably going to end up sewing that one just to be sure. That one, I don't really know where to put either of them. These are going on the black horror jacket. I got these from a lovely website called Rocknrollsuicide, all one word, rollsuicide.com. It's run by a lovely woman called Angie. And if you've been to any of the rock or metal festivals in the UK, you will recognise her stall as Rocknrollsuicide, because it's got loads of patches. It mainly deals in like metal bands, punk bands, horror films, cult classics, including back patches, like coffin shaped back patches. So if maybe that might ring a bell, and her like back wall is tartan, it's fantastic, and she has great selection, and she trades online as well, especially in this time when we're all having to stay inside and staying safe. It's good to build up the collection. And I thought while I was doing the old denim one, I thought I may as well include a few on there. The horror jacket, I ended up buying three for the horror, and they were only like £4 each, which is great. I think this one was £3, but that one's definitely £4, but there's some good prices, and she does send them out straight away, so that's good. I'm going to put that in the horror pile. I want to call it the horror pile, even though it's got like rock music patches on. Now these two, I'll do these two together as well. This one was from about 20 years ago when I was building up the first jacket. And I just was buying patches because I liked them. This one's obviously a Marilyn Manson one, meant to be like the American flag. And that's dead floppy. I'll tell you why, because it's been on the hoodie. And I think that's where it lived for ages. Then this was actually the first one I sewn back on when I decided to do the battle jacket. and before I took the sleeves off, this is the one that I kind of practiced on. I've sewn it on the top left breast area, and once I did it and I applied the back patch and a few others, I thought, actually, that's a waste of space. I can probably optimize the space a bit better than that. So I've took it off and I'm going to decide where to put it after. And same with this one, I did sew it on. This one's a new one. I don't remember where I got this one. It was fairly recent though, because I don't remember having any Kiss merchandise back then. But this is a newer one. I've got it probably either off eBay or from some market stall or something. And these two are going to probably either going to be like that, something like that together, because they're the same size and shape. So this is going on the battle jacket. This one, I mean, obviously it's just a little, it's only cost like $1.99 and it was off eBay. I can't remember the name of the store, but they do a lot of things like this, and I do like the Scream movies. I did try and watch the Netflix series, but I wasn't too sure. I know there's people on YouTube who collect masks, who turn the nose up at Scream masks, because there's so many of them in the world, but that's iconic. It's part of my, I mean, I would have been 11 when Scream came out or something, I think. Yeah, 2000. That's probably before then. I'm probably overselling it. But yeah, I just thought it was a nice little addition. So that's going on the horror jacket. I'll do these two ones together. So these two, right, these two are ones that are going to go in different piles, but they're from the same time. This one was on the denim jacket, being removed. Iron Maiden, Brave New World Tour 2000, so it was a bit of a weird time for them. That was when Blaze Bailey was in. Yes, it was before Bruce came back, so that's when Blaze Bailey was in. I think that was, it was the year 2000 I bought it, so that's probably why I thought, oh, it's a new one, I may as well buy it. But it's still a good patch. It has their logo on it. It's good writing, it's a good size, and it will fit on, under most back patches. But I don't think it belongs on the jacket, because I am expecting a new Maiden one soon. I will explain that in a second. But that is a good patch. But for now, I'm going to put it in the donate pile. Now this one, Limp Bizkit. I think this must be a rare one. Nobody else has seen it before. This one I'm sure I got from Geordie Jeans back in the year 2000. Although it says 2001, so they've just contradicted myself there straight away. Yeah, from them, because Limp Bizkit was probably the biggest band in the world at that point, and I was a huge fan. I'm still a big fan. And this was on the hoodie, and I usually used the hoodie for like trying to look like a cool skater dude. I'm obviously still trying that, obviously. But yeah, everyone seems to like this one, and I like it. And this will go on the battle jacket. And interestingly, it'll fit perfectly, because it's quite skinny, it'll fit perfectly on the waistband area of the jacket. Is that what you call that part of the jacket? I'll explain it in a moment, but that is going to just, I want to put the rest on first before I apply it, because I don't want to run out of space. So that's going on this pile. Now, we're coming to a few odd ones. This one is a WWE official Macho Man Randy Savage patch. And it's like it says, embroidered patch, still in this packet, authentic WWE, made in 2017. I got this as a gift off Wayne. I do really appreciate it. It's just, I don't know what to do with it. I really do not know what to do with it. I'd feel bad if I sell it or give it away. But then again, I don't have anything to do with it. So I'm going to put this in a fourth pile called I Don't Know What to Do. I do like the Macho Man, but I don't know if that fits in with all the bands and stuff that I'm using. Or you can see what's coming up next. Right, this is the first back patch I bought, which is Metallica's Creeping Death. I wanted the back patch to be Metallica, because I absolutely love Metallica. I don't care what people say about them, I just absolutely adore Metallica, and all their artwork is fantastic. So I thought that should be the back patch. So this is a reprint, I think, because it says 2017 on the bottom. And I've had this for about a year, because I was going to start this back patch last year in time for download. It never happened, unfortunately. I think I was just too lazy. But now, because we've been stuck indoors for weeks, I've had time to do it, and I've learnt myself to sew properly. So yeah, this is a great patch. I've got nothing against it. It's just, I put it on and it does match the other patch that's on there. You will see it in a minute, because of the purples, the blues and the greens and the black. But I don't know, it just didn't sit right, and it's also too big. I mean, I've had to cut down the one that's on there now, but it just didn't fit. And I thought, I mean, this is not the end of the world, I can get a new one. So I did get a new one, and I will show you it. So that one's going to go on the sell/donate pile for now. I mean, I'm not going to give that one away for free, because I think it's worth a bit of money. But yeah, so that's the patch that I haven't used. So now on to the jacket. Okay, this is might be a bit difficult from this angle, but I'm going to try and keep everything at the same shot. So this is the jacket so far. So what I've done is I've removed the sleeves quite carefully. It's got a nice little frayed look in it. And I mean, because this is a shark denim jacket from the year 2000-ish, from Geordie Jeans. It's quite a dark denim. You don't really get that sort of like stonewash sort of look denim anymore. It's quite vintage looking as it is. So that's quite good. And as you can see, just from the off, if that makes sense, is the new back patch, which is sewn in, and I've sewn that all by myself. Nobody helped us. It's on there, good and proper. And I did have to trim it at the sides a bit, just so it fit in the barriers of the, somebody will probably collect, I think Janine, I think Janine's my friend, I hope she is. Janine will probably correct us if she sees this, but this is, I think this, you call this the seam, I don't know, I'm really sorry, don't know anything about jeans and stuff, but, yeah, it just fit in this little box here, which makes it look a bit more, like, you know, as it's supposed to be, and the one above is Red Hot Chili Peppers. I know that doesn't go with Metallica or AC/DC or Alice Cooper or anything, but I love Red Hot Chili Peppers, I did at the time, and the patch is lovely. I'll show you it close up a little bit there, if you can get that in there, the light there, the lovely purple with greens and pinks and blacks there, really cool. And this is obviously Search and Destroy, Seek and Destroy, sorry, with Kill 'Em All, Metallica, and I love it, I love anything with skulls on, Metallica, love old school, love the colours, red, black, white, fantastic. Obviously that's a print as well, that one's from the same range, I think, because that's 2017. And on this back here, we had this AC/DC one that I'm going to show you in a minute, Iron Maiden, a couple others there. I unstitched them. This one here was done by my nana, grandma, and she, God rest her soul, she used to sew everything I used to give her. She was very good, and that stayed on there, that's it. I'm kind of doing this in memory of her and kind of carrying on her legacy. So that's those two, and then if we go further down, you will see this nice shiny AC/DC one. I'm not the biggest AC/DC fan, I do like them, but I'm not as big as Metallica or Chili Peppers or whatever. But it's a great patch, and it fit just right underneath the back patch. There is a little gap there, which I might put some studs just to kind of fill in that. But it looks good as it is. And that's, I sewed that all by myself as well. I mean, that one took a little bit longer because it was like just a difficult shape, you know. I mean, it's I know it's an oblong, but it's like, it's a bit, you know, I might go over that one again actually, because that stitching and that's a bit, that's fine, it'll stay. And this one here, this Alice Cooper one here, that's actually iron-on. It's on really well. The only bits that are kind of racky are like the ends of the letters. I think I actually bought that for the horror jacket, and for some reason thought, oh, it's going to go good on the battle jacket, so I just put it there. So I've kind of screwed myself for space there, haven't I? Because this is what I was going to talk about, is that one fits like up there really well. That Nirvana one, and then two square ones, like album cover ones, will go really well there. So that's great. Just flip the jacket over just so you see the ones in the front. Oh, well, did I just throw them in the bin there? So I've only got two on the front, so it looks a bit weak. I've got this nice Aerosmith one from 1998. It's like a flame effect one. My nana sewed that on it. She did a really good job because she sewed it on the pocket without sewing the pocket together, which is very hard to do, apparently. So she was a master seamstress. Typical nana. I've left the Le Chat logo on because that's quite cool, quite vintage. And that Twisted Sister one there, it looks like a sewn-on one, but it's an iron-on. And I've noticed that the bottom, this round bit here, is coming away a little bit, so I might have to re-iron it, because that does work, and go around with it with with thread as well, or at least just the bottom bit with thread. So yeah, so that's that one so far. So I'm gonna pause there and show you the black horror jacket. And we're back. Yes. Basically, what I filmed yesterday of this jacket, I don't know what happened, but the file got corrupt for some reason. I was trying to sync it with my MacBook, and it just didn't translate for some reason. It just crashed when I was like reviewing it. I don't know what happened. And then I tried to get it back, and it wasn't salvageable, so I had to delete it in case it affected anything else on my phone. And then, so I thought, right, I'm just gonna have to film it again. So it's a new day. Yesterday's anyway. Yeah. So this is basically going on at the horror jacket that I've promised you. There's also a few things I'm glad I did actually, because there's a few things I forgot to explain in that other video. First of all, when I said that I was waiting for some new patches to come in, I have ordered some like individual ones, but also somebody contacted me. I was selling a lot on Facebook Marketplace, and they contacted me in private and asked if I wanted to do a trade because they had quite a big collection. And I said, yep, I'll give you a list of bands, and we were just talking about stuff. And you notice I had two that he really wanted that I wasn't selling, but I just showed them anyway. And he was like, I really need them. The two of the really old ones from about 20-ish years ago. Which was the Linkin Park Hybrid Theory album cover. It's like, it was silver with a red soldier on it, and it was really nice. I was going to put it on my denim one, and also the System of a Down Toxicity album cover, which is really well detailed as well. So they're both good patches. And he said, I don't want to trade unless I have those two, otherwise I'll just buy the other lot off you for whatever. And I said, well, I don't really want to give them up, but you know, okay, well. And then like after a few hours, I just had to think about it, and I thought, you know what, it doesn't matter. Look, he obviously wants them more than I do, so this is a nice to get like a nice fresh start, buy, have 10 ones that I want, you know, that'll save us quite a lot of money. So he showed us a few. I've got quite a lot coming, and you will see them when they come. I'll do some sort of unboxing for you. And just thank you to him. I'm still waiting for them. I know the post's a bit slow at the minute. He's got my ones that I sent over, but I don't know where his is. I mean, hopefully they are in the way. I do trust him. And yeah, so I will explain the donate bit as well at the end of the video. But basically, this is what I'm calling the horror / goth / punk jacket, or just the horror jacket for short. Like I say, it was a Disturbia jacket to begin with. I'll show you the label there. So I don't know if you can see that in there. I've turned the main light on, and I've got the curtains open, so hopefully that's enough. That's Disturbia, it's genuine, it says large. Although I'm a bit fatter than that now, I'm more of an XL, but it does still fit. It still fits on. It's got a nice, like, you know, press stud buttons and a zip, nice silver zip. Pocket. It's meant to look like an army jacket, you know, kind of like a late 60s American army jacket, which are quite trendy still. And I'll just show you a few bits in it. So basically, the Marzen Hack one is from Rocknrollsuicide. Again, that great website, the great stall at the festivals. It was easily ironed on, and which it is. I think because I give them to me Nana to put on, as I explained with the other ones. She was great at this sort of stuff, and she actually really enjoyed sewing. So she did say it was actually probably better just to iron on. I think she put some wonder web on there just to hold it in place. And it was falling off a little bit because I've wore it at a few gigs recently. Well, not recently, but in the past couple of years. And it started coming away, so I re-ironed it, and it did work. And so it's just a matter of a good quality patch. That's obviously the Mars Attacks collector cards from the 1950s and 60s, but also was made into a Tim Burton film in the 90s, which is actually not that bad. People give it a bad rap. This one here was actually part of the jacket. No Gods, No Masters. Sorry, No Gods, No Masters. My Nana, mistakenly took it off thinking I didn't want it. But I said, oh no, that's fine. And she said, alright, I'll reapply it. So it's in a slightly different position to what it was when I first bought it. I bought the whole jacket itself on eBay for about a tenner. Second hand, which is great, I think, considering this cost about 40 quid, maybe more, like brand new. This one here is Wednesday 13. I got this one from Rocknrollsuicide quite recently with the Clockwork Orange and the Lost Boys ones. This is a new one. This is from his last two albums. So from Condolences and... Oh, what's the newest one? The newest ones just came out as well. Oh, God, I'm kicking myself. So that's the front. As you can see, a bit bare at the minute. And this is the back, which is, as you can see, is the main event. Right, this is... what made it into a patched jacket rather than just a jacket that I wanted to keep as it was because it was good as it was. What I had here, where the patch is here, was Born to Kill, a bit like on Full Metal Jacket. So this jacket altogether is inspired by Full Metal Jacket, or if you want to call it a full denim jacket. Anyway, so, and it said Born to Kill with the peace symbol, and it was good, but a lot of people were saying, oh, it's a bit, you know, especially in this day and age to go out with, even though it's a fairly new design. When I say new, I mean in the past 5-6 years. So I thought, you know what, I'll just slap a big old back patch on it, which is what I did. So I'd actually like you in the last section, because this was the first back patch I bought just for this. And obviously I love Misfits, I love all of their iconography, I love anything with skeleton skulls on. This fit perfectly, and I put this in place because I thought it would be quite a funny joke, because that looks a little bit like a pelvis, but in hindsight it looks like I've drawn it on myself. So what I've done is I've ordered about this sort of size chunky patch, four leopard print cramps patch, which excuse me, is going to look really good. I don't know where that hiccup came from. And these are the patches I want to put on it, so I don't really know, because I think that might sit nice there, and that might go quite nice like up there or something, or there. I mean, I don't really know. I mean, unless that one can go there and that one can go there. I don't know. I think when I've got more patches, I might be able to decide, but there for that one. So that's the horror goth punk jacket. Still great. One of my ones that I still wear at gigs and things like that. So basically... only thing to kind of mention now is the one thing is what inspired me to take this back up was not just because I want to carry on the jacket that me and Anna started, but also because I was inspired by a new charity that, well, it's not new, it's been going for a while now, but it's a charity that I've just came to my light in the past few months called Patch Amnesty. And basically what they do is, it's kind of like the patch charity shop in a way, because they buy and trade and sell charity, and sell patches like this and give the money to a charity. They give them the charity, the what am I talking about? They give the money to Mind UK, which is a very good charity. They've helped me before. And if you are looking for help, I would suggest Mind UK is a great one. There's always like local branches. There's one where I live in Washington. There's loads around the Northeast. They're a great UK-based mental health charity. So he's doing a very good thing. So you can find Patch Amnesty on Facebook, Instagram. They've got an eBay account. They put some really good... some of the ones I've sent them are going to be on there soon. I won't tell you which ones, but they are quite unique. So yeah, so that's it for now. So hopefully next time you see one of these videos, it will be a unboxing of patches or a tour of if you want to call it a tour of the finished jacket or jackets or what improvements I've made. And you know, as you can see, my nana's done a really good job with that back patch there, so I kind of take from her. She was the one who taught us how. So if you want to do it yourself, it's not hard, actually. It's not a difficult thing to do. It is a skill to like kind of get used to and stuff, but you can't really use this. I wouldn't recommend a sewing machine. I think I've heard sewing machines aren't very good for this sort of thing. You can buy sewing kits from all over. You can buy them from supermarkets, department stores. You can buy them from places like Wilco or B&M, places like that, where you can just buy like a little starter sewing kit where you'll get a needle, some thread. You'll get a few other bits, some pins to hold the patches in place. I would look up, go on YouTube and look up sewing patches on a jacket. There is a lot of videos that do good tutorials. And that kind of gave me a little bit of a little bit of help in hand as well, in the fact that I thought, am I doing this properly? Obviously, for the needles, I would recommend the finest needle you can find, so it'll go through all the material very smoothly. Some people use fine threads, but I find that snaps quite easily, and it doesn't hold it in as well as I use a sort of slightly thicker one. That sort of hold it in better, and it's stronger, and it's easier to like kind of thread as well. Also, I use a bigger needle just so it's like kind of I know that I've done it. And also, I mean, you can add some like little button badges, which I'm probably going to do, and some studs and things like that. So yeah, hopefully this has opened your eyes a bit to more to what my current hobby is in the lockdown, and you know, something maybe to take up in the future. So yeah, hopefully this has inspired you. So I'll just leave you with that, and I'll put all the links below in the description to Patch Amnesty, to things like Rocknrollsuicide, all these websites that I've mentioned. Okay, thank you very much, and see you later. Bye.